Greetings, one and all. This is Greg with a special report on the semi-truck. And it's only Monday, not our usual Wednesday or Saturday, because I thought the news was hot. So the photo that I've chosen here today focuses on, if you go to Google Maps and you look at the distance between what's called Rockland, California, and the semi or the gigafactory of Tesla, that distance is about 130 miles. So I wanted to bring this up because there's kind of an issue that's lurking, a question of fraud. And what that question is if Tesla has a 300 mile battery in both of the semi trucks that we're now seeing in test, why is it that those trucks were only able to go 130 miles before they had to recharge? And that's the focus of our talk today. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. Thanks again for joining us. If this is your first time on our channel, please take time to like and subscribe. If you're returning, welcome back. And we could really use your help on Patreon as well. So I have to admit our graphics aren't terrific today. And I think there'll be some forgiveness given what we're covering. In particular, what I was surprised by was Elon Musk tweeted photos of the new semis as they were leaving the Gigafactory to deliver an supposed 80,000 pound load to the Fremont factory of batteries for the Model 3. The issue that popped up is both trucks, so in theory, if both trucks have a 300 mile battery, they should be able to go from the Gigafactory 250 miles to the Fremont factory without a problem. The issue, it didn't happen. Why? The answer could be that, hey, the batteries are incapable of that, and that really doesn't work. That's one possible answer. And so I sort of posted on there, Nikola had suggested that Tesla might be a fraud, hence why the batteries aren't able to go the full distance. Thanks to the ambulance for popping by at a bad time. So to continue, I put the Donner Party on our video. One of the most famous stories in California is of an entity called the Donner Party. They're a group of travelers, I believe, coming from Pennsylvania and headed to California. The problem they had is that they were supposed to hit the mountains of the Sierra Nevada above Reno in September, and they were delayed and didn't get there until October. So after they arrived in a place called Truckee, California, which is now Donner Pass at 7,000 feet elevation, they ran into a problem, which is 40 feet of snow for their wagon train. We're in 1846 at this point, so basically they were stuck there for most of the winter. And things got so bad that they had to revert to cannibalism for those who stayed alive to tell the tale. So why is this a big deal in the case of Tesla? And the answer is simple. Right now, I'll put some graphs on our Tesla Fan Insight spot on Facebook, but what you'll notice is that at this time of year, the temperature range in March at the 7,000 foot elevation is probably between 15 degrees in the nighttime and about 45 degrees during the day. When the Tesla battery is forced to go through those mountains, they have to deal with the fact that the colder it is, i.e. below freezing, the battery has to use a lot of energy to get itself back into a good operating temperature range. So therefore the range that or the battery that would be used to provide more power to pull that 80,000 pound load up the mountain is being used to warm up the battery. So because of that battery consumption in the cold, that vehicle has to do recharges in a place called Rockland, California, which is, again, only 130 miles-ish from the Gigafactory site, so they don't run out of juice. I expect that when we go from doing this trip in March to actually doing this trip in July, and I want to say in the July-August time frame. I'm also going to post a chart of average temperatures at 7,000 feet so you guys can see what that looks like. But basically, I expect that by the time we get into the warmer months of spring and summer, that truck will be able to make the trip to the Gigafactory without too much difficulty. But it still raises the question, is the problem or the reason why they're getting half the battery range the warming process that the battery is doing, or is it the fact that you're pulling an 80,000-pound load up a 7-foot grade? The answer to that question we'll obviously find out later on, and we don't know right now, but I still think the question is an interesting one to pose, because it does bring up a bunch of conversations from both Daimler and Nikola in which they suggested that Tesla's ability to go the 300 or 500 miles that were described by Elon Musk is not going to happen. My suggestion is that from what we're seeing, it's not going to happen during the winter months, and Tesla will have to figure out how deliveries will occur if they're going to rely heavily on their own trucks to make that run. But I think that there are a couple of interesting points to that. One, the fact that they're dealing with both the weight and having to go at 7,000 feet is a good thing, because there are a bunch of other places in the world that may end up using these trucks that are going to want to see data on how these elevations and cold temperatures are managed by the truck. And it having to go through this on a regular basis allows there to be a lot of data collected. On the flip side of this, I guess you do have a half hour worth of recharge that needs to be done. It does slow down how fast the load might move during the colder months. But I'd have to say that it's great that there's any vehicle that could even attempt this range. And one would think that if you weren't using the new Tesla battery and trucks, you'd only be able to go 100 miles at a time. And as a result, you'd end up with a sort of a bad situation when it came to how this truck was actually going to be working if it were not a Tesla. So I would, the top of my post was a suggestion of, is it fraud that the Tesla battery doth not do the full range that was articulated by Elon Musk previously? And the folks at Nikola had articulated that, hey, this range that he's claiming is on a flat surface, and the temperatures are sort of above freezing, so therefore the battery isn't doing any extra work to prepare itself to work properly. So I think, this is an interesting circumstance. Is it a big deal? Is it a suggestion that there's fraud, that the new battery and the new truck really doesn't work? One could argue that because they truly are not going the 300 miles articulated. There are other questions that were raised. For example, there are two trucks. You'll notice that one of them has a fairing, which is a piece on the roof that allows the wind to more easily move across without slowing down the range of the vehicle. And it's interesting to note that Elon chose not to put a fairing on both trucks that's the same size to help with the aerodynamics. The black truck that has that does not have a fairing on it, or has a very small one, is it a handicap in terms of range if you're asking it to go long distances? So I'm surprised they haven't retrofitted that truck so that both trucks can get maximum range or distance through this process. In general, I sort of put a topic up there. Did the Tesla battery get ravaged similar to the Donner party back in the day? And the answer is it did kind of get ravaged by both cold and elevation. And I actually like the fact that the trucks are being put through this, because if you can get this kind of range under brutal circumstances like this, I think it portends good things for when this vehicle is put in situations, for example, the folks in Norway, or even we go to the desert for those customers that in the UAE that have ordered their trucks, they're dealing with super hot temperatures. So you're going to see similar battery issues going on there, where you lose battery as the power pack tries to cool itself off so it can have a comfortable operating range for the cells in the battery. So in conclusion, I just wanted to share, yes, both the Donner Party and Elon Musk have been a victim of the same phenomenon. 7,000 feet of elevation, cold, and snow can definitely affect how well these trucks move in terms of the distances they can go. Is it fraud? I guess you could argue that because it isn't going 300 miles. I guess the other question that comes up to mind is, why is that Elon has not chosen to run a 500-mile battery already? And only he knows the answer to that, and I guess we'll be finding that out soon in his next post. But for now, I would say I look forward to seeing the truck doing regular recharges in Rocklin, both before going from Fremont to the Gigafactory, as well as coming back from the Gigafactory. I think this will be where the truck will do its thing in terms of its recharge. I have to admit that I am planning to put some photos up on the other end, but I did want to sort of do a not great job here of my graphics management, and I just wanted to include one more photo just so that I can have it on the tape of that you guys can check out. And let's see, there it is, the temperature. So the one other thing I was going to show you just randomly here is just a Gigafactory. We're looking at Donner Pass, the average temperatures through the year. I think you guys might find it interesting to Google a place called the Donner Pass in California to look at what the average temperature is on that mountain, because this is what the semi is dealing with. And again, I think that when we go back into summer months, the truck will make the run easily end to end, because both elevation and cool temperatures are affecting this overall situation. Thanks for the comment that you shared there today. Unfortunately, I missed the comment as I was trying to deal with my visual aids here, but you know, we'll definitely respond in the below comments. Wanted to thank you again for taking time out to spend time with us here at Tesla Fan Insight. Mercedes and Nikola have claimed that the truck is a fraud, likely, and cannot do what it's stated it could do. But as Elon Musk has proved in many occasions, he and his engineers can do some pretty amazing things, including getting this to work. Again, need some help on Patreon if you guys would consider doing a buck to help support us. Chusmax gut au revoir, lehitroot, hoda hafez. And in Jamaica, we say, walk good man, enough respect. And look forward to our next conversation. And thanks to taking time out to visit with us. And look forward to your comments.